Hi friends, I am Dr. Shelmi Antony. Today we are going to discuss about excretory system of frog. What is the function of excretory system? In all organisms, it is responsible for the elimination of nitrogenous wastes. Nitrogenous wastes are of different types: ammonia, uric acid and urea. Some organisms excrete ammonia as their nitrogenous waste. These organisms are known as ammonotelic organisms. Some others excrete uric acid as their nitrogenous waste. These are known as uricotelic organisms. Some other organisms excrete urea as their waste. These are known as ureotelic organisms. In the case of frog also, the function of this system is the same. Frog excretory system consists of a pair of kidneys, a pair of ureters, urinary bladder and cloaca. So before going to the details of this portion, I just want to mention one thing. In the case of male frog, this excretory system, especially the urinary system, is closely associated with the reproductive system. So we are using another term, urinogenital system, in the case of male frog. We know that word is related with the urinary system. Genital, that word is related with the reproductive system. So together, urinogenital system. This is the diagram of frog excretory system. In this diagram, we can see kidneys, ureter, urinary bladder, cloaca and cloacal aperture. The elongated structures are known as kidney. From each kidney, a duct-like structure or a tube-like structure arises that are known as ureter, which carry urine from the kidney to the cloaca. And the opening of the cloaca is known as cloacal aperture. And ventral to this cloaca, we can see that bladder, urinary bladder, which temporarily stores urine. This is an outline of frog excretory system. About kidney, these kidneys are dark red in color, elongated structures lying in the limb space above the cello. And these kidneys are dorsally situated on either side of the urostyle. What do you mean by urostyle? It is the last vertebrae of frog vertebral column. Ventrally, these kidneys are covered by peritoneum, but dorsally these are exposed to limb space. What is the function of this kidney? It is used to extract liquid waste from the blood. In frogs, the kidneys are mesonephric. As we know, among vertebrates, three kinds of kidneys are present, which are different from each other in structure, position and embryonic history. That are pronephric kidney, mesonephric kidney and metanephric kidney. Pronephric kidneys are present in cyclostomes. Mesonephric kidneys are the permanent kidneys of amphibians and fishes. It is derived from mesode. Metanephric kidneys are present in reptiles and birds. Actually, mesonephric, the word meaning is middle kidney, that is in between pronephric and metanephric kidney. We are saying pronephric, mesonephric and metanephric. So in the case of frog, kidneys are mesonephric. And the function of this kidney is to extract liquid waste from the blood. As we all know, numerous nephrons are functioning inside each kidney, So we have to learn about the structure of nephron. What is a nephron? Nephron is the basic structural and functional unit of kidney. In this slide, you can see the diagram of a nephron. It's a tube-like structure. You can see a tube-like structure with the two ends. One end, you can see a cup-shaped structure. It begins with a double-walled cup-shaped structure that is known as Bowman's capsule. And inside this Bowman's capsule, you can see a network of capillaries that are known as glomerulus. And the other end of this tubule opens to collecting tubule. All these collecting tubules opens into Bidder's capsule. This is an internal view of the kidney. In this diagram, you can see that Bidder's canal. So we know many nephrons are functioning inside each kidney. All collecting tubules opens into this Bidder's canal. That Bidder's canal again opens to ureter. So the urine formed in the nephrons comes to the Bidder's canal, and through the Bidder's canal, this urine passes to the ureter. This ureter again opens to cloaca. Ureter is the duct which carries urine from the kidney to the cloaca. And cloaca is having one opening. That opening is known as cloacal aperture. So the nitrogenous waste is eliminated through this cloacal aperture. And ventral to this cloaca, we can see urinary bladder. In this diagram, you can see one important thing, that urinary bladder has no direct connection with the ureter. Ureter and urinary bladder both are opening into the cloaca, but there is no direct connection between ureter and urinary bladder. What is the function of urinary bladder? You know, it temporarily stores urine. In the case of frog, it is another function. It stores fluid for use during the period of water stress. When frogs lack a water source, water can be reabsorbed from urine in the bladder to rehydrate the frog. We know the frog skin always needs moisture. And when frogs on land, they can reabsorb water into blood, which help to replace water loss from evaporation. So this excretory system of amphibia is advantageous to their specific. So in the first slide, I told you there is a difference between male frog and female frog. In this slide, you can see two diagrams. The first diagram is the system of a female frog. Here, you can see a duct arises from each kidney. That blue colored duct, that is known as ureter. Ureter carries urine from the kidney to the cloaca. Here you can see one more duct, a green colored coiled duct. That duct is known as oviduct. Oviduct carries gametes or ovum to the cloaca. Ureter and oviduct both are opening to the cloaca separately. So in the case of female frogs, they are having two separate ducts, separately opens to cloaca. Which are the two ducts? Ureter and oviduct. Ureter carries urine from the kidney to the cloaca. Oviduct carries gametes or ovum to the cloaca. But the second diagram, it is the system of male frog. Here we can see only a single duct for carrying both gametes and urine. In the case of male frog, you can see testis is also closely attached to the kidney. So sperms are produced in the testis, but urine is produced in the kidney. But both of these, sperms and urine, carried through a same duct, that is known as urinogenital duct. Here you can see a duct arises from the kidney, a blue colored duct, that is known as urinogenital duct, which carries both sperms from the testis and urine from the kidney, and the duct opens to cloaca. In the case of female frog, two separated ducts, ureter and oviduct, for carrying urine and gametes respectively, and these two ducts separately opens to cloaca. But in the case of male frog, there is only one duct is present for carrying both these sperms from testis and urine from the kidney, and that duct is known as urinogenital duct, and that duct opens to cloaca. And in adult frog, they excrete their nitrogenous wastes as urea. But tadpoles, the larval stage of the frog, they excrete their nitrogenous wastes as ammonia. Frogs and humans have excretory system, but frogs have a cloaca, which collects solid and liquid wastes. Actually, this cloaca that collects undigested or waste materials from the rectum, and it receives urine from the kidney, and it receives gametes, and all these three things, fecal matter, urine and gametes, these three are expelled out through the cloacal aperture. Humans have cloaca only their embryonic stage. Human embryo is having cloaca. At one point in the development of human embryo, there is a cloaca, but which is split up into separate tracts during development. So that is a difference between frogs and a human's excretory system. So let me conclude today's portion. Frog excretory system mainly consists of a pair of kidneys, pair of ureters, urinary bladder and cloaca. The function of this excretory system is to eliminate nitrogenous wastes, and the frog's kidneys are mesonephric kidneys situated dorsally on either side of the urostyle, and urine is formed in the renal tubules, and urine comes to this collecting tubule, and through the Bidder's canal this urine passes to the ureter and then to the cloaca, and this urine is eliminated out through cloacal aperture. In male frogs, urinary system and reproductive system are closely associated because the male frogs have only a single duct, urinogenital duct, for carrying the sperms and urine. So it is known as urinogenital system. But in female frogs, two separated ducts are present. So separate systems are also be present. Thank you.